Welcome friends, in this video I am going to show you how to run a PowerShell script through Power Automate. Currently I am in the Power Automate homepage. To create a new flow, click my flows. This will populate all the flows which is created by me. There is a new feature is introduced by Microsoft in Power Automate called UI flows. You can see the tab here, just click on UI flows. This will enable us to automate all the repeated activities which is done in the screen, because in normal flow we can automate activities if that contains any API. Some of the legacy applications didn't have any API, so by using that UI flow we can easily automate it. Now I'm going to show you a simple example how to automate the PowerShell script from UI flows in a Power Automate. In the UI flow section, click new. This will show you two options, desktop app and web app. To automate the desktop activities, select a desktop, or if you want to automate any web related activities, click web app. Now we are going to automate the PowerShell script. PowerShell script which we have to run in a PowerShell application, that is a Windows desktop application. So I'm going to select desktop application and then click next. Here we have to give a flow name, PowerShell demo. Click next. There's a panel which opens with a input section. Here we can create a variables required for running the UI flow. If you are not giving any variables here, we can just hot code it and we can run it. So if you want to give some dynamic value, use this section to add a variable and values. Each variable has three type of values, that is variable name, the value for that variable, and then the description for that variable name. This is the PowerShell script we are going to run, categorizing this with three variables. One is command, PowerShell command, this one for folder path, and then file name. After the PowerShell script is run, we are going to open that output in a HTML file in a browser, MS Edge browser. So let's start creating a variables. First command, next folder path, file name, and add the values here. So once the input variables is added, then click next. So now we will have two activities to run in the UI flow. One is start your UI flow, this is a trigger, and another one is for recording all the activities what we are doing in the screen. That is, it capture all the keyboard events and mouse events. Let's click launch recorder. This will open a record application. If you want to get this launch recorder, we have to install a package. That package contains UI flow application, recorder application, and then a browser extension. I have already installed it, so I am getting this. If you are not installed, here itself you can get that link to download and install it. So let's click on this launch recorder button. So this will open a recorder application in top of the screen. You can see it here. And then click on this record button and then open a PowerShell. Use our variables to input to this PowerShell application. So let's click on this use input and click on command variable and then click on the PowerShell. Okay, once this is done, just give space in the PowerShell application and then use our another variable called folder path. Just click the folder path and click on the PowerShell. Once this is done, just use our third variable called file name and then click on the PowerShell. That's it, and press enter button in the keyboard. This creates the services.html in the path which I've given. So after that, we are going to open that file in a MS Edge browser. For that, I'm going to run script called start MS Edge and then use our input variable to enter the folder path. Then select the file name and click it in PowerShell window, then press the enter. You can see this services.html file is opened here. We are going to click done button to stop the recording. Just click done. Once this is done, the recorder activity, which is updated with all the activities we have done in the screen. Okay, and then click save. So in the meanwhile, we'll open the file explorer. This services.html is created. Okay, the UI flow is created now, and then click next. Click next. You can see before testing, we can give the variables. Okay, this is by default variables we have given. We can also change it here, and then we can run the test now to test it. Okay, so before testing it, there is one change we have to do. Go back to record and edit steps and expand this run select Windows PowerShell script activity and select launch select Windows PowerShell. In the application part, it shows the conhost.exe, which opens the command prompt instead of opening the PowerShell. To fix this, we have to add the PowerShell application path. Add a PowerShell application path here. And then click save to save it. Click next button. Next, to test based on these variables, click test now. So before testing it, I'm going to change the file name services1.html and then click the test now button. It will open the pop-up. So in the pop-up also click test button. So after click on the test button, don't do any activity in the screen, because the UI flow, which automatically runs all the scripts, all the activities what you have done earlier. Just click test, and then just few seconds we have to wait. You can see the PowerShell is automatically open. I haven't done anything. I'm not doing any activities. So the PowerShell script, the PowerShell application is opened, and then it adds the input whatever we have given in the variable. Puts whatever we given is automatically populated. I'm not doing anything. You can see services.1.html is added, and then it automatically press the enter. The script is run, and it's opened the Microsoft Edge browser. You can see the services.1.html is added. That's it, and then you can go back to your UI flow. You see your UI flow runs successfully. And then you can expand this, all are run successfully. That's it. So just save and exit. So the PowerShell demo UI flow is run successfully. So to test it, just click this test button, test icon. If you want to edit, just click edit button. If you want to delete it, delete icon here. Okay, so we can automate. We don't need to just come here and then click this test button. Instead of that, we can also create a separate flow. From that flow, we can just call this PowerShell demo to automatically open all the activities.
Please subscribe and click the bell icon to get more videos and stay tuned. And also give your valuable feedback on this video, and don't forget to click the like button. Thank you. Thank you for watching.